cold cast copper. In this tutorial, we'll be explaining the process of making a cold cast resin piece using copper powder. Now, in the previous videos, we've shown several techniques doing cold cast bronze, but in this one, I wanted to show some slightly different techniques using a mold we made in a previous video. This is a gel tin mold with an ArtKast brushable mother mold, and I'll put a link at the end of this video so you can find that tutorial if you're curious about that mold process we used to get to this point. Now, what we'll be doing for this process, to use a minimal amount of metal powder, we're using what's called the dusting process. And we're dusting the mold with copper powder. And this technique works best with soft silicone molds like this gel tin mold we're using here. And what we're doing here is putting in more powder than we actually need into the mold, and then jostling that around so it comes in contact with all of the silicone mold surfaces, and then pouring it back into the container. And what that does is it's a combination of static and just the surface properties of soft silicone that grab a thin film of that metal powder and hold it on the surface of the silicone mold. And once we cast our resin into that mold with that metal powder on the surface, the adhesive properties of polyurethane resin will then grab that thin layer of metal powder, and then it will all pull out with that cast resin piece, as you'll see here in a minute. So this is a very economical way to produce a cold cast metal part. Now the downside is you do have to be careful not to overly burnish the surface so you don't polish right through that veneer of metal powder. But this is a great way to produce inexpensive decorative parts that look like the metal that you've dusted on the surface of the mold. Now we have several resins that can be used for this process because at this point we're just filling in behind that metal powder and we just need a hard plastic to back up that layer of metal powder. But one of the things that I really like is to use a harder resin, something around a 70 to 75D, because the harder resins typically polish a little bit better than some of the softer plastics. So here we're using the ArtKast resin. This is the ArtKast pourable, and this is just a hard, about a 72D resin. And normally, if you don't add any pigment to it, it's going to cure kind of a bone tan color. But here I'm adding some polycolor brown, and that way we have a nice neutral tone underneath the copper powder. And that's important because if for any reason we've missed a little spot with our metal powder, or heaven forbid we accidentally burnish through a little bit of the metal powder, we're going to see that brown color rather than a stark white plastic or even that bone colored plastic. So real important to add some pigment here, and just a small amount of polycolor is all it takes to push that over to a nice brown color. Now with the ArtKast, we have a 3-minute working time and about a 15 to 20 minute demold. So we're going to pour that into our mold, and we want to take care not to create too much turbulence in pouring. So you want to pour, and I like to move that pour around the mold so we're not in one spot too long and we don't accidentally dislodge some of that metal powder. Now I bent a little piece of wire so I can hang this up later on a wall, and always good to have that ready to go, and always wear a glove if you're going to do this technique. But I've just bent some picture wire there in a little U shape, and I'm going to hold that there right at the end of the pot life so that that's locked into that plastic. Again, this particular resin formula has about a 3-minute working time and about a 15 to 20 minute demold. And there it goes. And you can see it starting to turn opaque where it's curing. And as we've talked about in other videos, you see that outside layer is still that dark brown. That means that's still curing. So real important to make sure that you give any thin areas in the cast plenty of time to cure. And one of the ways I measure that is what's left over in the mixing bucket. When those thin areas in the mixing bucket are cured, then that's a good indicator that I'm ready to demold my piece. So be aware of that. Really thin cross sections are going to take the longest amount of time to cure, whereas thicker sections will cure really fast. And one of the reasons we went with a gel tin mold on this is so that this could be seamless and avoid any need for cleanup later. Seams are really tricky to work with anytime you're doing a cold cast bronze or copper piece. So this minimized or eliminated, in this case, the need for any kind of seam. And it's soft enough that it pulls out with little wear and tear on the mold or on the part. And once we pulled out a cold cast part like this, you'll notice that it's going to have kind of a dull uniform color, kind of a reddish brown with copper metal. So when you pull that out, that's going to need to be shined. So what we'll do is we're going to demold our part and shine it up with some 4/0 steel wool. Now, ideally, the longer you wait, the brighter the shine you're going to get on a part like this. This is immediately after. It's still going to shine up nicely, but if you wait several hours, you'll find that you can get an even better shine, because once the resin has cured to its full hardness, it's going to polish better. So here we're using 4/0 steel wool to bring out that metallic look. And also, very important, the 4/0 steel wool is, I wouldn't go any coarser than that. 4/0 steel wool is ultra fine steel wool. If you were to use 2/0 or 3/0, sometimes that's too coarse and you could risk burnishing right through that layer of copper. So you want to take care to lightly abrade that surface with 4/0 steel wool. Now, as a final touch here, I'm going to apply some of the Sculpt Nouveau metal wax. This is the Verde metal wax. And what this does is gives us that look of oxidized copper. And to apply this, I'm going to stipple this on all over the piece and then pull it back with a soft paper towel. So in this instance, this actually helps to do this fairly soon after, because the heat from the piece exotherming still really helps that metal wax go into all those little crevices and really get a nice uniform coat all over our piece. So we're going to apply that everywhere and then wipe it back off. And the way the Sculpt Nouveau metal wax works is it will dry and then cure. And once it has completely cured, it is very difficult to remove. So it's real important with this step that you put on that metal wax and then immediately pull back what you don't want off those high points. If you let that sit too long, you'll actually have to use steel wool to pull that back off. So make sure you wipe off the excess immediately so that you don't have to abrade the surface any more than is absolutely necessary to bring out that shine. And there you have the process of cold cast copper. And again, this is a pretty economical technique, and especially using the ArtKast resin, that's a nice low cost alternative for art casting like this. The gallon kit of this resin is around $82. So a great way to produce low cost decorative items with a really nice metallic look. And as usual, all of the materials used in our video are available on our web store. I'll put links in the video description, as well as here in a minute at the end of the video, be sure to check out the tutorial on how we made the mold that we pulled this part from. So of course, you can find all the ArtKast resin and metal powders on our web store at brickintheyard.com. And if you don't, be sure to follow us on our Instagram page at Bitty Mold Supply. And thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe.